my name is Steve, and today I'll be checking out, for the very first time, a song called Dethrone by Bad Omens. This is a live performance recommended to me by Will Reddy. Thank you, Will. I've heard one song by Bad Omens so far in my lifetime, The Death of Peace in Mind. Really enjoyed that. Very impressive. Particularly the vocalist I thought was very good. So I'm excited to see what they can do live. Apparently this is a bit of a heavy song. That's all I know. So, gonna hit play now. And go! Ominous sound. Oh, I see a bass, possibly a drum kit. Really interesting sounds coming through so far. Bit of a strange intro. Disturbing voices, unusual like percussion.
This is Dethrone.
Oh, riff. Ooh, that's the hi-hats. Holy shit, I was not expecting that. Oh! Oh, it's so groovy! Yeah! Totally different from the other song! Okay. Oh, scream vocals, that's right. Kick drum locking in with the rhythm of guitars. Jesus. The vocal performance is off the charts. Oh yeah! I am all about this sound. Damn, good drummer. That's busy stuff. Not a sung note yet! What is that bell he's hitting? Devastatingly low scream. Nice. Yeah. A very enjoyable guitar riff. And those gaps. So much power in that voice. Damn. I'm getting a little bit of Cane Hill from this, like the heavier stuff. Jesus Christ, guys. Fuck. That song was relentless. It was just like, pow! I mean, well, the intro was very, like, gradual. It was dark and strange voices and percussive elements. And it's like, what the fuck is going on? And then they just launched into this absolutely, like, gut punch of a song. Wow, that was a surprise. Because the other song I heard of theirs, The Death of Peace of Mind, was very kind of gentle for the most part. It had some really cool busy moments with the full band, but it was just this delicate voice I couldn't believe. This was all fucking screaming the whole time. I was not expecting that. And such variety of it as well. Like, really, like, fucking low screams here and there. What surprised me in a way is, like, it was such a heavy sound. And normally, I don't see a bassist with quite that image of a bass guitar. It almost looked like a kind of bass guitar that Mark Hoppus from Blink-182 would be playing. But he's coming out with these mad riffs. Who just like, yeah, I got a nice, bright, green bass guitar. And fuck you if you don't like it. Why not? Play whatever you want. Doesn't matter. What matters is what it sounds like and what you feel like when you play it. It was dope. Very impressed with the drummer. It's really busy stuff, but complex, but it had dynamics to it and interest and variety. And every once in a while, he was hitting this insane bright bell cymbal sound. I wasn't quite sure what that was. I don't know. It didn't really sound like it was the bell of a larger cymbal. It was like it was his own, like a bell like you'd find on a cow. Not a cowbell, but like a kind of bing. It was very cool. I enjoyed that a lot. God, the fucking riffs were amazing. Vocalist is clearly very, very talented and intense. And yeah, it was an angry song and I loved it. I loved that. Thank you very much, Will, and also Rude, and Draco Malfoy, apparently, who's on YouTube, for saying that that's a good song to check out. I loved that. I can't wait to hear more Bad Omens. I can't believe I've only heard two of their songs and I've loved them that much. I find it really hard not to just binge through an artist when I find them doing these videos, because I want to potentially do a video when I listen to new songs of theirs, but I just want to put on an album and go. So we'll see. See what we do. If you think there's another song I should check out by them, add a comment, let me know. Hope you enjoyed this video. I certainly enjoyed that song. It was dope. Have a wonderful day. Oh, if you want to see more videos from me, there's a button you can hit to easily do that. Feel free. Up to you. Thank you for this moment that we had together on the internet. I appreciate it. Have a wonderful day, and maybe I'll see you in another video.